So this video is specifically for Debbie and Linda. Better watch it, I'll beat you. We're gonna make Brussels sprouts, but we're gonna deep fry them and basically mix them in basically a bacon jam. Where I work as American Legion, we do Friday night specials and we do two sides, and I was experimenting and doing these Brussels sprouts and Debbie and Linda fell in love with them. And they asked for the recipe, which when I cook, I don't measure. So I guesstimated, and then Debbie reached out to me and asked me to make a video to show them how to make it, because they don't know how to cook the actual Brussels sprouts, so I'm doing it. So here, we have Brussels sprouts. Here, I'm boiling salted water into the Oreo. We're going to boil first. This is because I'm using fresh. If you were using frozen, you could go straight into the oil. But I'm going fresh, so I'm going to soften them up a little bit first, maybe 5 to 8 minutes. Here, my oil. Got to turn that on. About high, medium, high. Here, I have butter. Turn that on to about medium. And then I have salt. Sherry, cooking wine. Black pepper. Chili powder, paprika, garlic powder, brown sugar, red onion. If you have white, use white, that's fine. I just like red better. And bacon. And also, apple cider vinegar. If you don't have apple cider, use red wine. If you don't have red wine, balsamic. I think I have balsamic. Found it. One of the African butter vinegar. So we're going to add our butter. And then I have Brussels sprouts, because you don't want them to get super soft and mushy. You just want to soften them up a little bit. Your friend. Just be careful, don't burn yourself. Yeah, so I've made it two different ways. One way I just deep fried my bacon and onions and made a glaze with balsamic and brown sugar, and you like those too. But I'm just going this way because this is the one I gave the recipe for. And ladies, if your recipe calls some I don't have out here, use it, because I honestly don't remember whatever the recipe. The recipe is also with stuff that I have at work. So this is what I have at home. Alright, so butter's melted. Red onion in. This stuff's very important. You mix that for a little bit. Don't touch it. Don't move it. Mix that for a little bit. Don't touch it. You touch it. Don't like stir it around a lot. Very important. Using Brussels sprouts saw last week. Now, if I have frozen ones, you can just deep fry them straight. But I bought fresh because the grocery store I shop at still has fresh. So that's what I did. So yeah. You can roast them, you can do lemon pepper on them, you could do curry. You have curry and a little bit of honey, that'd be good. Even a Korean, you know, Asian style with a Korean chili paste and soybean paste. Roast them up or deep fry them in that maple. That'd be good too. No, did you realize that too? Used in different ways. But this is what Daddy and Linda wanted, and Daddy and Linda better watch it, or else I'll beat you. Again. I'll show out a little bit once, you know, going up in the garbage, but you want your... It doesn't have to be crispy, but you definitely want to cook some of that out. I'll do the butter because I have the onions in, and bacon while it's that close, I suppose, so that's why. So when I do remove the gristles, they're drained a little bit, so there won't be a lot of water going into the oil. So as this cooks, I'm going to slowly add seasoning. Because you want to cook your, you know, seasoning, not cook it out, but you want to bring the flavor and the aroma out. When you cook spices, bring the flavor out. Also, if you have light pepper, use it. Whatever you got. This is not light. Oh, I have to do this. No, you can use whatever you have. I'm okay with that. Plus, I won't know. Unless you tell me. Again, I don't measure. I eyeball it. Or what I think is good. So, this will help caramelize too. I'm not gonna add any salt yet. If you have a colander, use your colander and sink this time. I'm just going to this way and let my whole thing smell on. And yeah. I'm also probably going to spray with this, and that's what I'm going to do out with this. You can cook these ahead of time and deep fry later. If you do that, when you pull them out of your water, you put them in an ice bath. So ice and water to shock them until they stop cooking. Just a small leaf left. So it is what it is. Got all the big pieces. It's fine. Alright. So they're still nice and bright here. They're not, so you know they're cooked, but they're not overcooked. They're not cooked at all. wine comes in. Sugar is also to get rid of some of the sweetness, cut it out. Let's cook in one more, and we'll be back. Alright, we're back. Our sauce is pretty much where I want it. Not super thick. Reduced a lot. Still a little liquidy, but not super liquidy. At this point, turn your heat off. I'm gonna taste it. That's where it's at. So once the oil's up to the temp, I do turn it down a little lower because I don't want it to get too hot. Very careful. Frozen and cook them straight from frozen. Debbie and Linda, the ones that work, were frozen, so. Doesn't matter. I just like fresh because I have them as an option, so I use it.
They'll get there.
We almost done, folks.
cut across these ones. And sauce. Sweet, salty, tangy, crispy but tender. So good. See y'all there. Hope you like it, Debbie, when I bye.